Eric, what is the status now of the governor having to resign or not resign if he gets into this campaign full
bore? Doesn't have to.
He doesn't have to.
No.
But isn't that, doesn't that set up conflicts of interest with some campaign donors who would be giving money to a candidate and doing business with the state of New Jersey at the same time? Wasn't there some...
There was some concern. Yeah, there were questions about that and concerns over it. The campaign believes they've worked that out. With, you know, the era of these super PACs, Jim, even if you can't give directly to the Christie campaign fund, you could give to another PAC. Mm-hmm. You know, that, and there are, I mean, there are unfortunately many loopholes and ways, ways around that. And he has said all along that he doesn't intend to resign. He intends to continue to do the job of governing New Jersey while he is campaigning. And I think, you know, depending on how he shows in these early primaries and whether he, you know, is headed down that road to victory, that'll make that'll play into whether he's going to resign.
Fundamentally, at least the system was that you could not accept campaign money from any one or by a person or individual who was doing business with the state. And a lot of the big contributors, some of the big financial organizations do business with the state, also are expected to contribute. And of course, you can use all the money you can get. But you say that now with this new ruling that you can...
Yeah, I mean, and Christie's, look, his lawyers have pored over this, you know, in the months leading up to this to make sure that there is a sound structure in place that would allow those contributors to basically, I don't want to say skirt that law, but to contribute in a legal way. Mm-hmm. Now, whether
the money would eventually get to him,
to the campaigner for others who would support him in the campaign. Yeah.
Well, so it is going to be an interesting time. Now, the first primary. Well, now first up is the Iowa caucus. Is that right? I think isn't that.
It's the Iowa caucuses have lost a little bit of luster, and a lot of candidates have the Iowa straw poll anyway, leading into the caucuses. You know, that was usually a big deal.
Yeah.
A lot of the candidates have said they're not going to participate in that because the participation rate in Iowa in that straw poll has dropped considerably over the years. The Iowa caucuses, those will happen with the candidates campaigning there, that'll be a solid test.
But
in
these
that part
aren't imminent primaries or caucuses or what have you. There's
no, you've got
away.
Yeah, you know, I mean, you're talking about early part of next year getting into the teeth of this thing. So you're going to have a lot of campaigning and jockeying between now and then. The first debate is in August. Fox News is sponsoring that first debate. They've said they will limit that first debate to the 10 leading candidates.
Now, wait, that is August of this year or next year?
Yeah.
This year.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to start it. 10 candidates. Right now we have 12. I believe Governor Christie would be 13, and I don't know who they are.
And you still got a couple more.
There's
you got
two more.
Yeah,
Ohio's governor.
Yeah, they're going to come in. Yep.
And about, so there'd be a total of 15. They will have to somehow winnow it down to 10.